So one of the players that I was looking forward to the most seeing was Matt Corral, Golden Corral out here. We're back with Matt Corral, the Ole Miss quarterback, because I think this dude has so much talent. It's just a matter of can he limit those crazy games that he had, right, versus Arkansas, versus LSU. He is my pick to be this year's Zach Wilson, if you want to call it. It's, like I said, we'll have to wait and see. Let's go ahead and get into the tape breakdown. All right, Matt Corral, the junior quarterback out of Ole Miss. You see the stats here, 33 touchdowns, 14 interceptions. We're starting off, and look at this throw right on target here, Dontario Drummond, and you're going to see his name a lot. Okay, Drummond was a beast in this game, and he clearly came out and stapled himself as a receiver to watch here, too. He's another one of those guys, senior year. Let's see how he does. But nonetheless, you just see the poise from Matt Corral in the pocket. Look at his feet. He was so calm, so relaxed. It looked so easy to him. And that throw, you know, yeah, it wasn't a hard throw to make. But, you know, and again, Dontario Drummond is a great receiver. We're going to see him out here a lot, doing a ton of great things. And this offensive line did a great job throughout the game. And you're going to see this by the Ole Miss offensive line. They did a great job allowing to protect Matt Corral throughout the game. But Matt Corral made some really good throws. We'll continue it on here. But just some simple things like the pocket, the feet looking so calm there. Just something maybe we didn't see as much of him from last year. Really, really calm feet. You like to see it. Onto this next throw here by Matt Corral. Just a little over the middle of the field. A dart right between the defenders. This is just another one that, you know, made it look easy. Really not an easy throw. He made it look easy. Here's one with pressure in his face. A nice little throw there, nothing too crazy. Just wanted to show that one off with a little bit of pressure in the face. Nice pocket again. And this one, though, was one of those, okay, is it decision making? Let's take a look at what he saw, right? This is what he saw. You're looking at this. So this is a cover three, a simple cover three. You got two linebackers over the middle of the field. You got two flat defenders, one right of the screen. You can't quite see one left over there. And then you've got your three deep halves there, or deep quarters, whatever. So he's looking over here. He's trying to fit it between the flat defender and the deep half. But let's take a look at this just one more time here and kind of determine whether or not Matt Corral made a bad decision here. Again, I understand what he was trying to do. He was trying to fit it in between that flat defender and the deep half. Ultimately, it's a throw you probably shouldn't make. However, I don't think it was the worst decision out there. It was definitely a tight window throw. Just couldn't quite squeeze it in there. Again, you could argue that might be a pick six even potentially. So you got to be careful on that. We were talking about Matt Corral. One of the biggest things with him is that decision making, right? So let's keep an eye out on that. Let's continue it on with the film, though. This is a little simple throw here to Drummond, who's going to be running. It's an RPO, and Drummond's going to be running like a little slant here. Watch his throw in between the safety and this linebacker coming up. Nice little throw there. It makes it look pretty easy for Matt Corral. And then you see Drummond doing some of the things that he was doing all night long there. On to this next throw, another RPO or play action. Just play action here. Easy throw for Matt Corral, but it's one of those throws you got to get done. Play action we're seeing here from the goal line cam. Easy throw. You probably could have made that throw. I could have probably made that throw. First down, you move the chains. Now, here's a big play. Fourth and two early on in the game, up 9-0 in the second quarter. Matt Corral running, using his wheels. He definitely has him, but taking a big shot, man. Definitely taking a big shot here. So let's continue it on, though, as we move forward here. Here's another one where he's using his wheels, as we were saying. He's going to use his wheels throughout this game. He had like 55 yards rushing. He definitely has wheels. There's no question about it. He can move. He's got good mobility. He doesn't have Malik Willis mobility. I'd say he's like 4'7 guy, but he's got some good wheels on him. On to the next throw here, second down and eight. This is the one where it's a little bit of a decision-making thing again. Just maybe not a throw you make. It wasn't the worst decision I've seen, but one of those throws you probably shouldn't make. Let's go on to now the second quarter, and this is the final drive of the first half. And oh my goodness, hold on, we're not done yet. We got to see this again. Did you just see what he just did? I mean, come on, man. This is a strike, a delivery package, FedEx, UPS on a dime. And you know what? Let's show it again for one more good time, because you just can't. I mean, this might have been his best throw of the game. Just look at this, getting us over to the corner here, right over the corner, right between the safety. I mean, unbelievable. That's arm talent at its finest. And he's going to continue this drive here, delivering a strike for a first down, getting him into field goal range now. But he's going to throw one more throw here to Drummond for a first down. And first and goal, you know, and they were able to get a field goal out of that as time was draining. This is another one of those throws. Let's go ahead and take a look at this again. So I'm going to put a little bit of blame on the receiver for not turning his head sooner, because that route should have been hot, or there should have been some level, like that receiver should have been paying attention at least a little bit, and it's like he didn't expect the ball at all. So again, that's a little bit, you know, one of those things where it may have been 50% on the receiver, 50% on the quarterback there. Just one of those, it's a good defensive play by Louisville. Let's continue on now, on to the third quarter. Matt Corral, and ooh, look at this little play. I mean, the trickery there. Now, it ended up being an eligible man downfield, but just you seeing the ability that Matt Corral has, the Zach Wilson, the Patrick Mahomes type of ability, right? That we, you know, we were talking about, as we saw with Zach Wilson, the little creativity. You always love to see that kind of element to your game. That was a great throw. We just saw there just a little bit off, but over those three defenders, great throw as well. We can take a look at that again. Nice base here by Matt Corral. Pretty solid footwork. Getting a little bit close on the feet there, but yeah, a little bit inaccurate, but that was a tough throw to make. On to this next play here into the end of the third quarter. Second and four. Now watch, he's looking to this outside receiver. He sees the cornerback fall, gets off the read, comes back over here to Dontari Drummond, and great decision. I mean, again, looking right here, sees that corner, and then nope, he makes recovery, comes back over to the left, find his receiver wide open between that safety and the corner. Great throw there by Matt Corral. On to this next one here, deep shot to Drummond. Just, you know, we'll take a look at this from the back cam. Now, it was turned back by a holding. I think by the right tackle over there was a holding. But you see it, a good decision, good overall pocket mobility there by Matt Corral. Good decision. That's what you like to see. It was a holding called back. However, they're going to drive down, and Matt Corral going to, whoo, we're talking about bulldozing. Is he Derrick Henry out here? I mean, I don't know, but I don't think so. But you see that bulldoze over him one more time. This is one touchdown pass of the game. He had a couple of that were called back, of course, on that one trickery to Jerron Earley, I believe. That one was called back by an eligible man downfield, and then the other one by Drummond was called back by a holding. So you had those two throws, but that was his one touchdown pass of the game. He also had a rushing touchdown we saw earlier. Let's continue on fourth and four to finish the game. Little slam pass, easy pass to Drummond there. Nothing too crazy. So overall, recapping, Matt Corral, Golden Corral, how did he do versus Louisville? I think he has made some serious improvements this offseason. I was really, really happy to see this. Now, the Louisville definitely struggled in this game. Ole Miss was outpowering them on the offensive line, whether it was defensively too. They were really a mismatch for this Louisville team. However, Matt Corral did it in his own right. I felt like he's made some improvements. Some of those question marks that we were talking about in his full breakdown, whether it was the decision making, whether it was some of the, you know, tuck and run, the ability there that maybe sometimes he takes his eyes off the field. I felt like it improved here in this game. We saw early on with his feet how calm he looked. His mechanics looked good. He looked really sharp throughout the game. His accuracy was really good. And you could say, well, the RPO-heavy offense definitely confused this Louisville defense, and it was just a mismatch. Lane Kiffin does a good job with that. But in his own right, I think Matt Corral was really accurate throughout the game. He made good decisions for the most part. I think they had like two or three bad decisions throughout the game. There were decisions that weren't necessarily terrible, but decisions maybe you question. But every quarterback, I don't care who you are, Tom Brady, are going to have question marks throughout the game. I think for the most part, he did a pretty good job. I think that, you know, his decision making was pretty dang good throughout the game. 22 of 32, 281 yards, a touchdown. He also had 55 yards on the ground and a touchdown as well in the run game. So yeah, he looked really, really good. His arm talent was on display. As you saw with that one sideline throw, was unbelievable, man. Not a whole ton of deep shots throughout the game. Obviously he had a couple that were called back, but that arm talent was still looking good. I think the highlight for me personally was that one throw, as we're talking to the sideline, you know, over that corner between the safety to Drummond on the sideline. That was nuts. But yeah, I had to watch that over and over and over again. I could watch that over and over again. With that being said, Matt Corral looked really, really good versus the win versus Louisville. And I'm excited to see him continuing on and get into a tougher opponents versus some of these SEC teams. With that being said, that's going to conclude this one for Matt Corral. Let me know what you think. Do you think he is looking like he could be a first rounder? He is a first rounder to me right now. We'll have to wait and see as we continuing on. But he's got some ups and downs. Let's see if he can kind of get some things on track. But anyway, I hope you have a great day. My name's G-Sling. I'm doing my thing. And of course, I hope you do too. And enjoy your day. I'll talk to you later.